Hello friends, welcome to the new session. In previous class we discussed about the chemical properties of halogens. In that one thing it remained and that one is halides. When an element reacts with halogens, the formed compounds are known as the halides. Generally, these halides have ionic nature. And this ionic nature decreases as the size of the halogen atom increases. From that, we can express the ionic nature order like this. Order of ionic nature. Metal fluorides are more ionic than metal bromides. They are more ionic than metal bromides. They are more ionic than metal iodides. Metal fluorides are more ionic than metal chlorides. Metal chlorides are more ionic than metal bromides. Metal bromides are more ionic than metal iodides. If an element, will come to the next point. If an element forms two types of chlorides, if an element forms two types of chlorides, the chloride with higher atomic, the chloride with higher oxidation state have more covalent character. The element with higher oxidation state have the more covalent character. If an element forms two types of halides, the element in higher oxidation state have more covalent character and the element in lower oxidation state have more ionic character. Suppose we will take an example. I am taking tin as an element. This tin forms two types of halides, SnCl2 and SnCl4. Among these compounds, here in this compound, the tin oxidation state is +2. In this compound, the tin oxidation state is +4. The compounds in which metal is in higher oxidation state shows somewhat covalent character. With lower oxidation state, ionic character. So, element with lower oxidation state have more ionic nature than the element with higher oxidation state. SnCl2 has more ionic nature than SnCl4. SnCl2 has more ionic nature than SnCl4. Similarly, we will go for this one. PbCl2 has more ionic nature than PbCl4. So less oxidation state means it has a more ionic nature. More oxidation state have compounds have more covalent nature. So these are the properties of halogens. We will discuss about the chlorine preparation methods and properties. Chlorine preparation methods and properties. This chlorine was first prepared by Schelling. Chlorine was first prepared by Schelling. Its name was given by David. So its name was given by David. It was first prepared by Schelling. So what are the preparation methods of this chlorine? Laboratory preparation method. Decantation process. When HCl undergoes oxidation, when HCl undergoes oxidation, in presence of cupric chloride at 723 kelvins, we will get chlorine gas. So this is the preparation. When HCl undergoes oxidation with oxygen in presence of cupric chloride, you will get the chlorine gas. Another method. When HCl is oxidized with magnesium ion, again we will get the chlorine gas. So the chlorine MnCl2 for chlorines. Another preparation method. When sodium chloride solution with sulfuric acid. Oxidized with manganese dioxide, then also we will get the chlorine gas. So we get 4HCl plus 4H2SO4 plus MnO2, 4NaHSO4 plus Cl2 plus 2H2O plus MnCl2. So these are the laboratory preparations of chlorine. This chlorine also prepared in Nelson's cells method. And this one is an electrolysis method. Nelson's cell. So chlorine is prepared in Nelson's cell. In Nelson's cells method, we have an U-shaped perforated steel vessel. this is a new shape perforated steel vessel. Perforation means having small holes. In this, a graphite rod is placed. So this is the graphite rod, which works as anode. Here one opening is present. Graphite anode. This perforated steel vessel itself works as cathode. And this arrangement is placed in an iron tank. This one is placed in an iron tank. From here, steam will be passed. Steam is passing, and from here hydrogen gas is removed. Here chlorine gas will be liberated. So this is the total arrangement. So in Nelson cell method, an U-shaped perforated steel vessel is present. Which works as cathode. In that, a graphite rod is placed, which works as anode. In this perforated U-shaped steel vessel, electrolyte is sodium chloride solution. An electrolyte is placed, and this one is sodium chloride solution. NaCl solution. So this is the NaCl solution, brine solution. Brine solution is taken as an electrolyte. Solution is electrolyte. So look at what happens. On passing electricity, this NaCl undergoes dissociation. The chloride ions liberated chlorine gas. I will write the electrolysis reactions here at anode. At anode, oxidation of Cl- occurs. So when Cl- undergoes oxidation, you will get the chlorine gas. Cl- when undergoes oxidation, you will get the chlorine gas. At anode, Cl- will going to undergoes the oxidation and chlorine gas is liberated. At cathode, these Na plus ions comes out from the perforation. Na plus ions here, when chlorine gas is liberated from here, when NaCl undergoes dissociation, which ions you will get? Na plus ions and Cl minus ions. Cl minus ions undergoing oxidation and chlorine gas is liberating. Which ions remains in the solution? Na plus ions. These Na plus ions comes out from the perforation, means these Na plus ions will comes out from the U-shaped steel vessel, will comes outside into comes outside from the solution. So these Na plus ions will comes out from the solution. these Na plus ion will going to react with the steam. Will going to react with the steam. Otherwise, we will write like this. First, water undergoes the dissociation. H2O undergoes the dissociation. It undergoes dissociation plus H plus and OH minus. These Na plus ions will going to react with OH minus ions coming through this water, and you will get the NaOH. This H plus ions will gain the electrons and become H2 gas. This H2 gas comes out from the steel vessel like that. So here outside this steel vessel, outside the steel vessel, NaOH droplets are formed. These NaOH droplets, when become big, you can collect the sodium hydroxide here. You can collect the sodium hydroxide at this place. This is the Nelson cell method. At cathode reduction takes place. Na plus. So this is about Nelson cell's method. So I will tell you once again. In Nelson cell method, a U-shaped perforated steel vessel is present. In that, a graphite rod is placed. In this steel vessel, sodium chloride solution behaves as an electrolytic solution. This U-shaped steel vessel is placed in an iron bag, which works as cathode. Graphite rod works as anode. Electrolyte is sodium chloride solution and passing electricity. This chloride ions undergoes oxidation and chlorine gas is liberated. Na plus ions undergoes the reaction with OH minus ion. Then you will get the sodium hydroxide solution. This H plus ions react with these H plus ions will going to reduce and become hydrogen gas. This hydrogen gas comes out from the vessel. So this is about Nelson cells method. This Nelson cells method, we can prepare the chlorine gas. Now we will discuss about some of the properties of this chlorine. Physical properties. Soluble in water. It is a greenish yellow color gas. Easily liquefiable. Easily liquefiable gas. Next, come to the chemical properties. To the chemical properties. First one is reaction with metals. Reaction with metals. When chlorine reacts with metals like sodium, its chlorides are formed. So when sodium react with chlorine, you will get the sodium chloride. When aluminium react with chlorine, you will get AlCl. When iron react with chlorine, you will get FeCl3. So this is the reaction with metals. So what you have to remember is, if a metal have two different oxidation states, when that metal react with the chlorine, the metal chloride formed have the higher oxidation state of the metal. Suppose take iron, iron state oxidation states are Fe2 plus or Fe3 plus. So that means iron can form FeCl2 and FeCl3. But which compound is formed when chlorine reacts with iron? You will get FeCl3. So that is the thing you have to remember. If the metal have two oxidation state, the metal chloride formed is the major one, in which the metal contains higher oxidation state. So FeCl3 is the major product in this reaction. You will not get the FeCl2. If it is formed, it is in minor quantity, again it is going to oxidize to FeCl3. Next, reaction with non-metals. Reaction with non-metals. This chlorine is a strong oxidizing agent, hence react with both metals and non-metals. When it react with the non-metals like phosphorus, you will get PCl3 and PCl5. It also reacts with sulfur. Then we will get H2Cl2, SCl2, like those compounds. So this is the reaction with non-metals. Next, reaction with compounds. When carbon monoxide react with chlorine, you will get carbonyl chloride, COCl. When NO react with chlorine, you will get NOCl. When sulfur dioxide react with chlorine, you will get sulfuryl chloride. So these are the reactions with the compounds. So when carbon monoxide react with chlorine, nitric oxide react with chlorine, sulfur dioxide also directly react with the chlorine to give the compounds. So when chlorine react with carbon monoxide, you will get COCl2. The compounds are known as the addition compounds. SOCl2, COCl2, NOCl, all these are the addition compounds. Now we will discuss with the reaction with ammonia. reaction with ammonia. Ammonia react with chlorine in different ways. When ammonia react with chlorine, you will get NCl3 and HCl, or you will get ammonium chloride and HCl. To balance the equation, then you can find when you get this product and when you will get these products. So these are the balanced equation. Here the number of moles of chlorine in both the reactions are same, but the number of moles of ammonia is different. That means with more amounts of ammonia, your product is ammonium chloride and nitrogen. With less amounts of ammonia, your product is NCl3. With less amounts of ammonia, you will get NCl3. With more amounts of ammonia, you will get the ammonium chloride. This is the reaction with ammonia. Next, reaction with bases. Reaction with the strong bases. Chlorine react with strong bases in two different ways. Like chlorine going to react with strong base like sodium hydroxide and potassium hydroxide in two different ways. With dilute and cold sodium hydroxide, you will get sodium chloride, water and sodium hypochlorite. With hot and concentrated sodium hydroxide, you will get sodium chloride, water and sodium chlorate. So what happens here? Look at here, with dilute and cold sodium hydroxide, you will get sodium chloride, water and sodium hypochlorite. With hot and concentrated sodium hydroxide, you will get sodium chloride, water and sodium chlorate. How many chlorines are there? 5, 6. Now this chlorine going to react with calcium hydroxide also, with the dry calcium hydroxide, chlorine will react with calcium hydroxide, you will get CaOCl twice, CaCl2 and H2. CaOCl twice, CaCl2 and H2. At the same time, when chlorine reacts with the calcium hydroxide, you will get these products also. CaOCl2 and CaOCl2 and water. So these are the reactions. This CaOCl2 and CaOCl2, CaCl2, all this mixture is known as bleaching powder. So bleaching powder is is the mixture of CaOCl twice, CaCl2, CaOH twice and 2H2. In bleaching powder, the major component is CaOCl2. The major component is CaOCl2. So this is the major component in bleaching powder is this one, calcium chlorohydrochloride. Major component for bleaching acid. Here the chlorine oxidation state is minus 1. Here the chlorine oxidation state is plus 1. So in its name is calcium chlorohypochlorite. Calcium chlorohypochlorite. So this is calcium chlorohypochlorite. In calcium chlorohypochlorite, the chlorine oxidation state here, this chlorine oxidation state is minus 1 and this chlorine oxidation state is plus 1. Now look at the reaction with hydrocarbons. Reaction with hydrocarbons. So what is the reaction with hydrocarbons? When chlorine reacts with hydrocarbon like methane, you will get the CH3Cl. And this one reacts with ethylene, then you will get the CH2Cl and the CH2Cl, 1, 2 dichloroethane. So this is the reaction with hydrocarbons. With hydrocarbons you will get this addition product. So, with alkenes you will get the substitution product, with alkenes you will get the substitution products. When it reacts with hydrocarbons, chlorine have more affinity towards the hydrogen. Sometimes what happens is this chlorine will take the hydrogen. Finally you get the only this carbon and chlorine containing products. Suppose you take this CH4, when this one reacts with the chlorine, the final product is this one. This is the final product. It means all the hydrogens are displaced with the chlorine. Now we will go for another reaction. Chlorine is a strong oxidizing agent. It oxidizes terrace salts to ferric salts. oxidizes ferrous salts to ferric salts. It oxidizes sodium sulfite to sodium sulfate. It oxidizes sulfur dioxide to sulfuric acid. It oxidizes iodine to iodic acid. So in all these examples, the oxidation state of this atoms increasing. Here the oxidation state of sulfur is +4. Here the oxidation state is +6. Here the oxygen +4, +6. 0, +5. So oxidation states are increasing. Increasing in oxidation state is known as oxidation process. The thing which doing this oxidation is an oxidizing agent. Another oxidizing property is Na2H2O3. This one is known as sodium thiosulfate. Sodium thiosulfate is oxidizer to sodium sulfate. Sodium thiosulfate is oxidized to sodium sulfate. In all these reactions, chlorine behaves as an oxidizing agent. So these are the chemical reaction, chemical properties of chlorine. And the next one is uses of chlorine. This chlorine is extensively used in textile industry as a bleaching agent and to kill the bacteria, all those things in water. For sterilizing, chlorine is used as a sterilizing agent. Sterilizing agents kills the bacteria and microorganisms present in water. Chlorine is a bleaching agent, means it removes the colored matter from the substance. Chlorine bleaching action is due to oxidation. It also used as a bleaching agent in paper industries to prepare number of poisonous gases like phosgene. Phosgene is COCl2, tear gas CCl3NO2, and Lewisite. This is Lewisite. This is Lewisite. Lewisite is a poisonous gas. This is tear gas, CCl3NO2. This is phosgene, COCl2. All these poisonous gases are prepared by using the chlorine. So these are the uses of chlorine. Okay, this is the end of this chlorine topic. We will meet with the new topic on the next day. Thank you.